We're going to talk about another fashion trend. Actually, it's quite a perennial trend. It is also my favourite colour, red. We're going to talk about how to do red. Now, I know a lot of people are very shy about this colour because red is a very unshy colour. Basically, it's very, very out there. You wear it, it kind of draws attention, hopefully in a good way. So here are a few tips on how to wear the colour. Number one, girls, when you wear red, you have to wear makeup. I know that sounds very to the extreme feminist. You're like, why can't we do an Alicia Keys and go barefaced? The problem is, red firstly is such an attention-grabbing colour that all eyes will be on you. The other reason is because red is so bright, if your face is sallow, like even if you have really good skin, I think a light layer of, just a light base layer like a tinted moisturiser or BB cream would be nice just to even out your skin tone so you don't look sallow and dead. And I think just a hint of blusher is pretty important when you're wearing red, especially if you're Asian. And you know, most Asians we're a bit yellow toned. For me, I like to really go very cliche and all out, red lip, red top, but you don't have to do a red lip when you're wearing red. Like a nude colour works fine as well. I just think that colour on your cheeks and an even skin tone goes a long way. The second most important thing when wearing red is the right shade of red. Now I found this out over the years of, you know, modelling and later, you know, doing stuff for TV and stuff. When people used to dress me, I realised that they would put me in different shades of red, and I have found that this particular shade, which is, I think it's close to a true red with a hint, the slightest hint of orange, works best for me, like almost veering towards a vermilion. It makes me look brighter and fresher. Let me show you a few other shades of red. Okay, so this I think is like a true red. Like when people say true red, this is the truest red. A true red is slightly blue toned to almost neutral. Like I look okay in this shade of red, but you will see that the bright, slightly vermilion-ish red actually still looks better on me. A true red though suits almost anyone. So if you're unsure of what shade of red to wear, I think this is a safe bet. Okay, so this is a slightly warmer shade of red, the kind that I prefer, that I look better in. You can see it's just a hint of orange, vermilion-ish. And if you have, like me, a similar neutral-ish skin tone that's not super fair, like I'm probably like a medium skin tone, I think this looks really nice. Like I said, I like to pop this with a really bright lipstick in the same-ish shade of red, but it looks nice with a nude as well. So that's a more warm red, not a true red. Okay, another variation on red. This is like a really cool red, almost veering on maroon. Now, you see it when I use it close to my face. This is not the most flattering tone on me. So I only get these things for bottoms because I don't like wearing it near my face. Now, trick to looking prettier, wear a color that's most flattering to you near your face. If you want to wear colors that, like, let's say you don't look good in yellow, I would suggest wearing it on the bottom rather than close to your face. So this one, like I like this skirt, but I would not buy a top or a dress in this color because I think it makes me look a bit dead. However, if I think if you're a more cool skin tone or if you're very, very fair, this could look really nice, and it's also a really classy shade of red. Okay, finally, this is like a maroon. Some people may argue that this is not red. My mother, who anything remotely red she calls red, she would say this is red, but if you compare it against the others, it's almost purple. It's a maroon because it's red veering on purple. So just now we had the red veering on orange that was warm. This is red veering on purple that's cool toned. I like this pair of shorts very much, but again, I say I don't wear this close to my face because it's not the most flattering. Although I think on a really fair girl who is a very cool tone, this could look really nice. It's very important to pick the right shade of red, as I said. You know, just try on different shades of red. Trying on is free. And you will slowly begin to realise what shade looks best on you. The next thing to remember when doing red is to think about your personality. Like if you have a very big personality and you're very confident, you can do top-to-toe red, like a full-on red suit, a full-on long red gown. I personally love red because I have that sort of big personality. But if you're a bit of a more of a shy person, more reserved, you don't like all attention on you, then I would suggest doing bits of red. Like you can do a red bag, or you can just do a red lipstick with an all white outfit that's quite nice. You could do a pair of red shoes with jeans, you know, so you have a hint of red without going overboard. So you can do a little or a lot. Accessories when wearing red, again, this is a bright, loud color. So the good thing about it is you technically don't need that many accessories. So let's just more, most of the time you can get away with just simple studs or just a simple choker. If you're like me, more is more. You can do a lot as well. But I'm just saying that red is good if you don't like to fuss about so many accessories. You actually don't have to pile it on when you're wearing something quite as attention grabbing. Another thing about accessories, now if you are a bit shy about wearing red, you can use accessories like a jacket to tone down the redness. For example, like if you were wearing a red top with jeans, maybe you could throw on a leather jacket or a denim jacket and that kind of tones it down. I think leather and denim look really, really nice with red. So that's the other thing to think about when accessorizing your red. Okay, tip number five when wearing red, quality and cut is very important. Like it's not to say you need to buy expensive clothes. I myself wear very normal, you know, stuff that I buy online, or I just buy high street brands. It's just that you need to make sure that the material looks good when it's red, because you know, if the material looks cheap, you get away with it in, I would say usually if it looks a bit cheap, I'll get it in white, black or grey, because you can't really see, for some reason the quality of the material doesn't show up as much. But because red is like such an attention grabbing colour, if the material looks cheap or it doesn't fit properly, the whole look just looks really, really off. So pay attention to quality and cut. Actually that's true for all clothes, but especially so for red. So those are my tips on wearing red. Now, you don't have to wait for Chinese New Year or for National Day in Singapore to wear this shade. It can be worn all year round, and don't be shy about it as well. You can wear a little or a lot, and you can also, you know, make sure you find the right shade of red. And trust me, you will be the lady in red. The wind is not cooperating. Okay.
Hey, you know, do the Facebook.
Oh, yeah. Right, so those are my tips on wearing red. Now let me know if you have any tips on wearing red or how you like to wear red. If I've missed out on anything at all, drop me a line in the comment box below. Also, if you've been following my fashion videos and if you found any of the tips helpful at all and you've incorporated them into your outfits, I want to see them. Remember to tag me on Instagram so I can see how all of you are wearing your red or off-shoulder or anything else. Otherwise, I'll catch you on Facebook, on Instagram, and on Twitter. Bye! Lady in red.